Like to call to order the June 15th Planning Commission meeting. We're about sound.
Move on up.
Turn it.
I turned it off.
Okay. We'll begin and Mr. Henderson will lead us in prayer. Noah will lead us in pledge.
Heavenly Father, thank you. Responders, watch over us.
Welcome to our meeting. We have our chairman is out of town. Present tonight. Gentlemen, we have approval of the minutes.
Chair, I'd like to approve the minutes with three additions added. I made a comment last meeting. Vice Chairman made a comment, and Kirkland. Okay. I'm making.
Have a motion and a second. All those in favor. Gentlemen, in front of you have the copy of the agenda. I'd like to have a motion to approve the agenda.
No move, sir.
Motion and second to approve. All those in favor? Motion carries. Have no presentations. State agenda. Before we go further, let me read the statement, though. Again, I'd like to take a moment to clarify that the Planning Commission is recommended body to the Columbia Commissioners. Zoning. Various requests tonight will be for final action on June 9th. Rest the board is paying a request to speak. Thus, we're less formal. Raise your hand. We recognize you. Come to the podium with your name. Next on the public hearing.
Thank you, Chair. This is a request for rezoning at 4224 Wheeler Road from P1, actually a portion of 4224 Wheeler Road from P1 S1 for expansion of existing mobile home park. Subject parcel, south side of Wheeler Road. On the south side of Wheeler Road. You can see the parcel here. We'll be talking about basically the bottom half of it as part of this rezoning. The properties around it currently zoned M1 or M1 to the east and west, S1 to the south, the existing mobile home park. To the north is R2 and S1, which is both residential and also a couple of churches. Aerial view of the site again does show the existing mobile home park and also the area around it. And we'll be talking about this little section here. And street view of the site again, it is currently used as a residence. Also, the plat, this is 4224, a very old plat, but it's still good. So. And so, let me explain a little bit about the backstory on this mobile home park. In 2002, it was rezoned from M1 to S1. Kind of the park had been in existence for well over 40 years. And so, that was rezoned to bring in the compliance with county ordinances at the time. They submitted a concept plan that we'll be seeing here in a minute, but then never filed an actual plat for that. So you see these tracks here were part of that original rezoning, and they were looking to transfer some property and found out that that hadn't been completed. So that kind of led us to where we are today, where we're looking to rezone, or they're looking to rezone this piece of property here for expansion of the park. And I will say that they have followed their concept plan basically to a T in regards to that. It's just kind of a bit of an anomaly that wasn't followed through with. This is the adopted site plan for the entire site. If we were to go back to the aerials, you would see that all these were built, as well as these were all built as well. But again, we are speaking about this section here. In terms of the applicant has given us a sketch plan, they're showing basically six more lots. Some on 4224, which is this parcel here, and also 4226 has two lots as well. In terms of future land use, this is within the Interest Activity Center, which does kind of call for more industrial and commercial uses, that sort of thing. In terms of the future land use map, staff is comfortable with this expansion. Again, it's fairly minor expansion of the use. It's been in existence for quite some time. There are I won't really say there are concerns, but again, one of the things from the original rezoning in 02 was that they would have to submit a site plan for the base of the whole site that shows the layout and also that meets county code. So that's kind of carried over into this, and also as an S1, they're going to have to do a site plan as well. And also, again, we are clarifying they will have to have a record plat of the area, which they've already done. Clarifying they'll have to do that. Again, staff is recommending approval of conditions. And here, again, the site plan for the entire property will be submitted prior to any placement of additional mobile homes on the property. Again, carry over from 2002. Also, record plat of the area to be rezoned, as well as the area that's rezoned in 2002, over the 90 days. That includes staff recommendation.
This is a public hearing. Applicant, did they answer? Don't mind, come to the podium, please.
Number 8 Amazing Grace Court over in North. Mobile Home Park is right off. There are plans to sell the homes that we own, homes that face. Brother has an interest. So we just want to set up the back part of those lots are going to become part of the park. Three of them happened in 2002. I don't know the fourth one, but
you're going to put homes on these lots?
Mobile homes, yes.
Yeah.
Questions? Thank you, sir. It is a public hearing. Is there anyone else who would like to speak against? Tony. Close the public meeting. RZ1. Motion and a second to approve. All those in favor? Carries 4-0. Item 2, which is also a public hearing.
Yes, sir. This is a request for a conditional use for a gym at 4812 Technology Drive. Property is located north of Martinez Boulevard and kind of towards the end of the cul-de-sac, and is currently zoned M1 light industrial. You can see it does border the R3 single-family residential neighborhood to the rear of the property, but the remainder of the surrounding parcels are zoned industrial as part of that commercial and industrial park there. This is an aerial of the site. While it was under construction, you can see there's three buildings. The request is for a gym to be located in this rear building, adjacent to that residential neighborhood behind it. The existing site with those three buildings and the parking and landscaping. And the site plan, it's a fairly tight site with limited parking. They do meet the minimum parking requirements for the gym to be located here. And they do also have a shared parking agreement with the property owner who also is using that middle building. So they have permission to use additional parking on the site. This property is located within the Martinez Activity Center, so a commercial use such as a gym is very appropriate in this location, and staff is recommending approval.
There again, this is a public hearing. Is the applicant here? I'd like to come forward and make any comments or any.
If you would, I've got a question or two.
Please come to the podium and name and address, please. State your name.
I'm Rachel Wilkes. Yes.
Got permission for the parking. And is that in writing?
It is not.
So that could be pulled if another person comes in?
As far as the conversation we had together, it's our hours are mainly after hours.
I saw that.
So from 5 to 8 p.m. Nobody's going to be there on that at that time. But the company that's in front of us is the water company, the owner of all the warehouses on the street. And that was the one he was talking about. It's not going to be any other tenants in that.
Okay, I'm just trying to protect you or thinking of you because pulled and say, look, 2 years ago said you're going to do this, and he sells the building.
Yeah.
Anyway.
Don't believe. So we have different classes. We have one per hour. Typically, going to have around 5 to 7. We wouldn't have any more than 10 just on personal trainer and safety issues. Yeah, there's just one store.
Thank you, ma'am. We're raising your hand. You have something you want to tell us? Okay, please step up.
Concerned about something being in writing for parking issues. I'll be glad to put that in writing and make
please sure. Please state your name and address.
I'm Sharon Thornton, 519 Rocky Ridge Drive.
Yeah, it was mainly just for your protection because I've seen these things.
Yes.
Somebody
understood.
Said, wait a minute.
Thank you, ma'am. Anybody else would like to speak for or against? None. I will close the public hearing. All for motion, please.
Here, I'd like to make a motion. The The approval for the conditional use file RZ17-05.
Motion and a second for approval. All those in favor? Motion carries 4-0. Next on the agenda, legal matters. Staff and commissioner comments.
Hey, Mr. Chair, this is a minor waiver. Again, this is kind of information only. 3687 Bay Point, they requested a reduction in their side and rear setback from 10 feet to 9 feet. Approved, I believe. This is a location. It is over in Westlake. At the zoning, again, currently zoned R2, so it's front and rear setback, or side and rear setbacks 10 feet. Because the site plan, they're reducing the 10 down to 9, within the 10% threshold allowed to be approved by staff administration. Staff approved the request on June 7, 2017.
Which that was for information. Any questions or comments?
Yeah, if you go back to there, the cantilever coping.
Not sure. I didn't ask. I didn't ask Pete over at Pete Elwine what that was. But I'm not aware of what that might be. I know what coping is. I'm not sure what cantilever.
That's expensive.
All right. Commissioners, do we have anything to add? Anything to add? Motion and a second. Item. All those in favor? Carries 4-0. We do have some public left. I'd like to make any comments.
You're welcome.
Thank you. Thank you. Gentlemen?
I move that we.
Motion and a second. Those in favor? Meeting adjourned. 6:17.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you, guys. Pass the microphone over.
Well done. Well done.